All over the world, every country is grappling with the billion-dollar question. When is the right time to reopen? Do we just let everyone out of the house now and say goodbye to grandpa and that one friend with asthma? Or do we stay inside forever and become a race of mole people who only leave the house for more toilet paper? These are the only choices. Well, yesterday, Boris Johnson, British Prime Minister and man who looks like he's just been in a pillow fight, announced that Britain's lockdowns will continue until at least June. And then he went on to lay out a possible plan for slowly reopening. Now, that it went okay. But then Boris also created a lot of confusion when he changed the country's coronavirus slogan from stay home to stay alert, which nobody really understands. Like, think about it. Stay at home makes sense. We all know what stay at home is. You stay at home. Stay alert. What does that mean? It's too general. Stay alert is something you say when you're boarding an alien spaceship or when you're searching for a parking spot. It's too broad. So, I understand why British people are confused. In fact, they haven't been this confused since they tasted seasoned food for the first time. Good Lord, what are these strange sensations in my mouth? It's like my tongue can see colors. Now, while Britain is going with the slow and steady approach, some parts of America are choosing a slightly different method known as yippee-ki-yay.
All of Colorado is currently under a safer at home order put in place by the governor.
And that's not stopping some restaurants from defying that order and welcoming customers inside.
This restaurant was packed yesterday. Video from inside shows there was a line out the door. Booths were packed, tables were filled. Very few of these customers were wearing masks. Obviously, there was no social distancing. And the owner of CNC here has made her feelings clear, posting these signs all over the front saying, "Attention, our freedom doesn't end where your fear begins. If you are scared, stay home."
God damn. I've been to brunches where I've said, "This food is to die for," but I've never meant it. Like, when did going to a restaurant become an act of revolution? I miss the days when the only political debate at brunch was, "Who invited Melissa?" And I gotta say, revolting against the government because of brunch has got to be one of the whitest things I have ever seen. This is like a khaki short sale at a hockey game. And it's not just Colorado's business owners who are defying the rules. In Texas, a Dallas beautician was jailed after opening her salon during the lockdowns. And after she was released, Ted Cruz rocked up to show his support.
Texas Senator Ted Cruz traveled from his home here in Houston to Dallas to get a haircut at a salon whose stylist was sent to jail for violating stay-at-home orders. Cruz says he wanted to show support for Shelley Luther. She was sentenced to 7 days in jail and given a $7,000 fine for keeping her salon open against the governor's initial orders. The Texas Supreme Court ordered Luther's release on Thursday. Governor Greg Abbott changed his executive order to remove jail time as a penalty for violators.
What are we doing when there's a police sting trying to go after beauticians for trying to earn a living? I mean, last I checked, there's some real criminals in the world.
What a twist. This salon owner broke the law by keeping her business open. And because of public outcry, she's now a hero being celebrated by Senator Ted Cruz. And you know, it's funny how in America, if you break the law and you look a certain way, well, then you're a criminal. But if you break the law and you look a different way, well, then the law needs to be changed because you're just a freedom-loving American exercising your rights. Now, I know some people think this woman deserves to be in jail, but for me, having to cut Ted Cruz's hair, that's punishment enough. Like, that should actually be everyone's punishment for breaking shutdown laws. You have to spend an hour with Ted Cruz. Guilty. Bang. I actually didn't even know that Ted Cruz got haircuts. I just assumed he ate it when it got too long. And that's why I say, mm-mm. And you know, I'm not gonna lie. I find it bizarre that haircuts have become one of the major flashpoints of the debate over lockdowns. Like, this is the one time when people should look to Donald Trump for leadership. He doesn't cut his hair. He just folds it over like a crepe. And finally, for an example of how dangerous it can be to reopen too quickly, here's a story out of South Korea.
This morning, 4,000 clubs and bars in Seoul are closed. At testing sites, long lines, as health workers try to track at least 5,500 people who went clubbing more than a week ago and might be infected. They say a 29-year-old man went to at least three nightclubs the night of May 1st, wasn't wearing a mask, and tested positive for COVID-19 last Wednesday. The city's mayor ordering all nightclubs and bars to close indefinitely, saying carelessness can cause the virus to explode. Daily cases are now spiking. 35 this morning, the biggest rise since early April.
Wow. One man in South Korea closed an entire city's nightlife scene because he went club hopping without a mask. And I guess that gives a whole new meaning to the term shut it down. He's also a pioneer because usually you don't catch a disease until you go home from the club, if you know what I mean. I don't know what that means, I just say it. Which, by the way, is why bouncers have to step it up in the age of Corona. Yeah, they've got to be the one blocking people like this. Hey, come on, man, come on. No shorts, no cap. Hey, man, what you doing here with a respiratory illness, man? You can't come in. I don't care how many girls you got. Come on, get out of here, man. Shit, gonna come in here with a respiratory illness trying to affect people with pulmonary embolisms and shit. So you can only imagine that everyone in Korea is probably mad at this dude. Although the good news is, I heard Ted Cruz is still down to go clubbing with him.